We will have differences. It is only human to have differences, but it is not the quality of a believing male or female to give up so easily. Don't. You need to try your best. You need to sit together. The Almighty has given guidelines of how to solve marital discord by telling us that there are several stages. If you cannot together resolve it, just the two of you, then only should you involve seniors from either side, and that is if necessary. The reason why I say then only is because, my brothers, my sisters, the initial problem that you may face within your marriage or within your family, the world does not need to know about it. Your close friends don't need to know about it. At times, even the broader family do not need to know about it. Do not unnecessarily relate your problems to others. It makes it more difficult to resolve. They will start interfering, and each one who loves you more will probably not be as tolerant as you would be with either your spouse or whoever the problem is with, and they might give you the wrong guidance out of love for you. They might tell you, fix him, leave him, you can do better, you will get married again, etc. This is the type of advice you hear from people. But if that's your first port of call, do you know what? You need to make sure that you've understood, I told the wrong person. I told someone who really loves me so much, they're not even prepared to give this person a chance. Sometimes when you expose what has happened in your own unit in terms of problem to those who are around you, you may have solved the problem, but a long time later, they all still believe that you have that problem. They may cause embarrassment, not just for you, but for your spouse, whom you've already solved the problem with. So therefore, understand who you're speaking to. When seeking advice, you may want to seek advice from someone who doesn't know either of you at a certain point. Then, if still you cannot resolve the matter, you cannot solve the problem, do you know what? Then you try something else. Then you may want to get the families involved. And like I have said always, it depends what exactly the matter is. If it is so big and so serious, then you might want to involve your family. If you are in a situation where you are facing, for example, physical abuse, we won't tell you, calm down, sit down, it's okay, forgive him, relax. No, that's unacceptable. You are not supposed to be abused physically as a Muslim. People might cite verses and so on. They have not interpreted them correctly. That's what it is. They might say, well, I'm allowed to do this. And hang on. You may think you're allowed to do things. I want to give you one quick example. In Islam, there are two types of dissolving of the marriage. One is through divorce issued by the male, and the other is through a nullification or a dissolution that has nothing to do with the male, but rather it's done by the justice system, the qadis. I'm sure in this country that's how it works too. Or in countries where they don't have that, then the panel of scholars. One of the reasons that a marriage can be dissolved is when there has been physical abuse. If physical abuse was permissible in Islam, why would the same laws dictate that you have the right to apply for dissolution of the marriage based on physical abuse? Whoa. Doesn't it show you that physical abuse is not permissible? Hence, I said earlier, when you are being abused to that degree, please involve people who are going to save you. Today you might be beaten, tomorrow you might be choked, and the following day you might be murdered. So don't let anyone tell you that, you know what, you must solve all your problems. Remember, at times the problem may necessitate that you have escalated it to a degree where maybe the marriage might break as a last resort. As a last resort, it is a gift of the Almighty as a last resort. The reason is, we will not impose on you to live in a situation that is unbearable. It is torturing to your mental health. Nobody should ever tell you, you must stay there. My beloved parents who are here, if your children are struggling in this way, do not give them the wrong advice. Do not lead them to suicidal thoughts in the name of solving family problems.